Hello summoners, welcome back to the channel, and in this video we will be playing around with the 565 Black Widow Deadly Origin. This is the first time I'm doing a face cam and gameplay simultaneously. I have uploaded a face reveal video, so if you haven't checked that out, but I still imagine for a lot of people this would be the first time they are seeing me. So hey, and let's talk about Black Widow Deadly Origin now. And she is still a relatively new character on my main account. This is the CCP beta, by the way. On my main account, I have her at rank 3 on Awakened, and I really enjoyed her, but she doesn't have much going on for her utility wise. She does have some really decent damage. When she came out, people said that she is basically a shock version of Gwenpool, like how Gwenpool has bleeds, she has shock, and that is pretty accurate, I would say. For the most part, Gwenpool does have more utility. If she's awakened, she have defensive ability reduction, she can tank infinite special attacks, and like with SP3 she has armor break, with SP2 she has envoy weight, which is basically a weaker version of power control. So overall, I would say that she has more utility, and even for longer fights Labyrinth, I do believe that she might have higher damage as well, as long as you can bleed the opponent. Now of course, there are a lot less shock immune characters if you compare it to bleed immune characters. There I dashed back twice and now I have degeneration going on, but it doesn't matter because the SP2 does a lot of damage. Use it, fight is over. And that is basically what happens in early Act 6. This is 6.1. But as you go deep, like again, with her not having that much utility, not finishing fight as quickly as other meta characters like Ghost, Corvus, characters like that, she is a character that is mostly just for fun. Anime, like playstyle wise, I really like her rotation, like how it feels to play her, but like the double animation, it just doesn't feel extremely smooth to me. After like the double medium or how it ends when I go for the SP2, sometimes like I was feeling like it won't connect or something. And you should keep in mind that she has a 7 hit combo, so that will inflate her hit counter a little bit, but of course like every SP2 is finishing it off, and this is actually pretty impressive. I was happy with her performance here in Act 6.1, and we will also take that abomination, by the way, even though she is not poison immune. She is an alright defender, doesn't have too much going for her there. After SP1, she does have like an evade kind of thing, I believe. So, and with her double medium, she could be a little bit annoying, I guess. But here again, we're gonna go for the same strategy. The shock themselves, like, they do a decent amount of damage. I am thinking about making like a damage comparison video between her and Gwenpool. That could be really interesting. Do let me know if you want to watch that in the comment section. And here we like Symbi Supreme had the armor phase on, and that does reduce the damage, I think. So but even then, like this fight pretty quick, 40 hits, not bad at all. And we will move on to this abomination. That domino is actually a great example of what a very simple node can do to her, because there, like whenever domino uses a special attack, you get power drain, and as like if you can't you reach your special 2, then you lose a lot of damage and the fight is much longer, and you're going to see that in a second here. But now with abomination, of course it's not a great matchup, and you should probably never take a non-immune character against this guy. But I did it just for fun to see if she can kill him before he kills me with the poison damage. And you'll see that she actually can, like after the SP2, it just has so much damage. It feels really good to fire off. It's a very satisfying special 2 in my opinion. Overall, where I would rank her, I do not think that she is anywhere close to top 5 skill characters. I would rather play with, what are the top 5 in my opinion? Nick Fury, Aegon, Celso Spider-Man, Blade, Killmonger. Elsa Bloodstone is better than her, I think. She has more utility, more damage. Squirrel Girl is also better in my opinion, and I'm sure I'm missing a few characters, but I don't think you should use Gem on her or Signature Stone. She does have a pretty good prestige, I think. So maybe that could be a reason. She's an alright defender, she is alright on offense, but overall, like, for a 2020 character, you do have certain expectations, and like, I don't think she performed that, because we already have a few Black Widows in the game, and Deadly Origin, I was hoping she would be a great new powerful character, and she has decent DPS again, but look at here, now we can't get to SP2, and that just makes this fight so much longer. Now our shocks are doing most damage, because like basic heads for 565 is pretty bad, the kind of damage that she's doing. She doesn't crit ridiculously, very frequently or anything, so she's a pretty basic character if you can't reach your SP2, and if you can, then for a range of health pool she could be really good, because one SP2 will finish off the fight, which is a great thing. But here, as you can see, we are 60-70 hits in and the domino goes down. Now, how can we make a video without going to Realm of Legends? So here it is, the Winter Soldier kill. She's not extremely suicide friendly either. She's not immune to bleed or poison. With some synergies, I saw that she takes reduced damage or something, but without synergies, just by a base kit, I do not believe that she is immune to bleed or poison. And on top of that, you need to throw her special attacks, SP2 especially. So not a suicide friendly character, but again, basically the SP2 damage, I feel like I'm repeating a little too much, but that is the only thing impressive that I found about her. She does have these inside charges. You get them for doing anything in the game, basically, except blocking. Like, you can dash back, you'll gain them, you can hit the opponent and intercept. Like here, you'll see every hit we gain an insight, and that's cool. And like, it's alright, she's a above average character. If you want to rank her up for fun, sure, go ahead, but otherwise I do not think that she deserves resources, like rare resources. But that is gonna do it for this one. Thanks for watching, have a nice day, subscribe to the channel, like this video, do let me know if you want to see this face cam kind of thing and more videos, because it is cool, but it takes more work, as you have to like record the gameplay, and I guess you can play and commentate at the same time, but I'm not there yet. So I basically play and edit a little bit, add the background music on ready on my phone, then transfer that to the laptop, and then on OBS I do the facecam voiceover, then put it back to my mobile, do a little bit more editing, and then upload the video. So it's a pretty long process when you have to do facecam videos, which is the reason in the future, I guess in most videos, I will still not have the facecam included, especially those that are time sensitive, like when a character is buffed, new characters come out, but it is something cool, and in streams we can have the facecam, which is great. So that's gonna do it for this one. Thanks for watching, have a nice day, subscribe to the channel for more content, like this video, share, and bye bye.